Grain handling properties in many communities represent the largest single investment under the protection of the local fire department. There was a time when the country elevator was used only for storage, but today an elevator often incorporates shelling, drying, cleaning, grinding, and mixing of grains and feeds. As these services increase, so do the problems of firefighting and fire prevention. In a small town, the group of volunteers who fight fires in these properties are often hampered by a lack of equipment, inexperienced manpower, and a poor water supply. But elevator fires are being fought successfully today. The key to this success is the proper distribution of water. That's why a sprinkler system is so effective. There are sprinkler heads inside the cupola, and at ground level, there's a fire department connection to charge the system. After the sprinklers go to work, it doesn't take long for the smoke to change to steam. The sprinkler system has brought the main body of fire under control. Now complete overhauling is carried out. After the overhaul or cleanup, a fire guard must be posted. Early detection, a sprinkler system, outside access, pre-planning. These are the ingredients for the successful control of a grain elevator fire. Each of these should be investigated and studied during the pre-planning session. The chief or whoever is in charge has to organize the pre-planning session and make sure his men have the proper attitude.
Same things over again, though. You guys know how important this is. Now, Gary, Bill, and I went all through the building earlier this afternoon. There's some small places where we can't all squeeze in together, so we better split up in three groups.
Bill and his group started up in the head house. Gary went to the first floor inside the elevator, and the chief took his group outside.
So our first truck will always come down here between the tracks and lay a line into the sprinkler immediately. Always remember, there'll be one person directing location of equipment. Speaking of water supplies, we are fortunate here to have a good one. Some departments have to rely on cisterns or other outside supplies. Our hydrants are well located, but when we come down here for our dry run, we better check the flow.
This is an example of portable fire equipment kept in most elevators. It's for the elevator personnel to use when fires first start. Every elevator should have a fire extinguisher capable of handling gasoline fires in the driveway. Since water is the agent most needed in elevator fires, water barrels and buckets and water-type extinguishers should be kept immediately available in all locations and kept in good working condition. This is part of the equipment which elevates the grain to the head house, where it is distributed to the various bins. It drives the main leg, which goes clear down to the pit. Now, if the fire has burned for any length of time, there may be danger of the motor and drive shaft dropping down the leg well. We always take calculated risks, but in each case, it is up to the chief to decide what's safe.
I don't think I need to tell you how important this outside ladder is. It lets us get up and at the fire without going up the main leg well of the elevator. This is the safest way to reach the top of the elevator under fire conditions.
Each bin has an access opening like that. Better memorize the location of all these openings for each bin. There's another opening in each bin at the bottom.
Always watch the outside spout, especially if there's a fire in the head house or cupola. Burning embers could slide down to this annex and we'd find a fire behind us.
These spouts provide a way for sparks, debris, and water to get into other bins. They must be watched carefully to prevent the fire from spreading and to avoid unnecessary water damage.
There's the man lift that employees use to reach the cupola. However, it's not recommended for firemen if the fire has been burning very long. As you see, it's operated by a rope, which could easily be burned off. If you do take the man lift up, be sure that you take a rope with you and have someone fasten the hose to your rope. It'll save you time.
If a fire were to break out in the main elevator, it's easy to see we'd have to concentrate part of our effort in keeping this fire from spreading.
It's quite a ways down there, isn't it? When there's a lot of heat and smoke in here, it's like walking a tightrope blindfolded. Be careful, because your next step may be 60 feet down.
You can usually depend upon some guy who doesn't know any better to open the door too soon. This provides a ready supply of fresh air for the fire. It doesn't need much help. The main leg well provides a perfect draft, just like the chimney in your stove.
This is one type of alarm system that has a wire running up and across the upper portions of the building. There are fusible links every few feet. When any of these reaches a certain temperature, it melts and activates the switch, which turns on the siren. Thermostats of this type are often used to supplement the fusible link arrangement. On most new installations, they are replacing the fusible links entirely. We better make sure that all the employees, the night watchmen, and the people living in the area are familiar with the siren.
These are the main power lines going into the elevator. If the elevator is heavily involved, these lines must be cut, as they may fall on firemen and equipment. As you know, we have it set up so Mel from the power company responds to all alarms with his line truck.